She's having to deal with the trauma, people just making completely false allegations about her. Carly has given detectives her statement so that they can continue to pursue her abductor.
I believe that there's an abductor still out there.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, that didn't age well.
The Alabama woman who claimed she was kidnapped after spotting a toddler walking alone by a highway now admits it never happened. Carly Russell said she lied to police about the whole thing.
You have anything to say to the community for lying to the community? Everyone was out there searching for you, Carly. Do you have anything to say? Mr. and Mrs. Russell, anything to say? Why did you lie on national TV?
Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today we are gathered here to discuss Carly Smollett. All right, now y'all already know the story. I don't even feel like we have to revisit the whole thing. Of course, we are going to give you guys a quick little synopsis for those of you guys who, for whatever reason, forgot or just didn't know about the situation. However, I feel bad for those of us that were, for whatever reason, following the story because we really thought this bitch was missing, lost, and in danger. But come to find, she was a big, fat fucking liar. I know that there are so many of you guys that were confused as to why I did not cover this story. However, if you haven't figured it out by now, since I'm actually a journalist by degree, I do not like to report on things prematurely, nor do I like to sit here and make 5 to 10 different videos just to get the clicks, the views, and the revenue on something, just so I could be the first one to talk about something, especially in this case when it's a sensitive situation and when I think somebody's a liar. Because in most cases, a lot of times, especially in 2023, a lot of motherfuckers do things for clout. So I really wanted to wait this one out, because I'm not even gonna lie, as soon as I heard about this story, I felt absolutely no emotion about it, and I couldn't understand why. Because most people, as soon as they saw this story, they were just like, I mean, a missing Black girl, oh my God. Because most importantly, most of the time when Black people go missing, especially when it comes to Black women, there are absolutely no resources put into finding these Black people. So to be quite honest with you, I kind of felt like a dickhead, because I was like, damn, why do I feel nothing about this? But now that everything's come out the way it has, I don't feel any type of way. And to be honest, I should start typing into my spirituality and shit like that, because I must really be some high priestess, because I have not been wrong about any of these hoaxes at all so far. But before we get into that, all right, tomorrow at 12 noon, you can start shopping my new merchandise. Isn't it beautiful? Isn't it lovely? Isn't it lovely? Isn't it beautiful? We got new merchandise. All the classics that you guys once enjoyed are now there. Some of them are revamped, but I just launched the Mafia and Chill collection. I now have cups, blankets, shirts, shorts, all types of stuff that you guys can enjoy while you watch my channel. So many other things that you guys can vibe out with. I'm so proud of this collection because I worked so damn hard to revamp this store. So it would mean so much to me if you guys go and you support the shop. Everything you need is going to be linked down below. And for those of you guys who enjoy my Haitian channel, I'm going to be doing 12 days of Halloween over there starting on Monday. So make sure you go subscribe. 12 days only on the weekdays. Weekends, we ain't posting over there. Also on Monday, I'm going to be relaunching my Haitian merchandise shop as well. So listen, we got launches on launches and launches. In addition to that, November 1st, we're also going to be relaunching the Media Hustle Shop, equipped with digital products for you guys. I know a lot of you guys enjoyed the YouTube planner that I have on Amazon, but now you guys can get the digital version, as well as different templates to help you guys out with planning your days, planning your social media content. All types of stuff is going to be in that shop. Like, I'm so excited for all of these drops.
And how can I forget, for those of you guys who want to be influencers or would like legitimate business advice, no fluff, no bullshit, I did set up a YouTube channel for Media Hustle, and I would greatly appreciate it if you guys would subscribe. I know, y'all, a fourth one, what the fuck, but honestly, the only way for me to help you guys is on YouTube. That's what I does. So please make sure you guys go subscribe. It's going to be linked down.
And I know you guys are probably like, okay, but what about the music though? You told us you was gonna drop music. What the fuck is the music? Bitch, that Black Friday. Yes, y'all, I'm dropping my song on Black Friday. After Thanksgiving is finally here. So please make sure you guys turn on all those notifications. But most importantly, follow me on Instagram, because Instagram gonna get that drop first. But most importantly, Patreon is gonna get the song way earlier than everyone else. So thank you guys so much for always supporting me, following me, and of course pushing me to actually get that song the fuck out. All right, so let's get into this. So earlier this summer, we were all terrified because we found out that a young Black girl went missing.
There is a kid just walking by themselves. How old do they look? Like a toddler.
Shortly after that 911 call, Hoover police in Alabama reported Carly Russell had disappeared. 49 hours later, she showed up at home and told investigators she had been abducted.
Now, one of the reasons I honestly didn't care for the story was because, one, I had so much going on. I was about to start a summer program at the time, so I was like preparing for that. But two, the story just honestly never made sense to me. Like, I'm a very huge advocate of children, so I would probably be one of those people to see a kid on the side of the highway and stop. But one thing that never made sense to me was the speed that she was going at. If I'm not mistaken, they said that she was going at like somewhat of a speed of like maybe like anywhere from like 60 to 70 miles per hour when she saw the toddler. I'ma say I'm an avid speeder, y'all. I don't go anything under 60. I'd be literally going 60 in a 40. So I'm just like, hold up. She was on the highway and she saw a kid on the side of the road. Like the shit, when I read the sentence, and it's funny because I remember I was talking to my boyfriend about it, and I was like, I don't know, the story just don't make sense to me. And I remember I saw a couple commentary channels talking about it, and they were the first ones to call it out. And people were dragging them for calling the situation out. And I was just like, ooh, y'all bugging. I'm not gonna be the one to say it, and fine. So I just let it rock. I was like, let's just see how this plays out. I mean, I hope she gets found. And I just left it at that, right? Then it came to a point where, you know, her parents started to come forward. And this is where a lot of people started to really be like, okay, something is really odd here, because her dad just looked a little bit.
We tried to hug her as best we could, but I had to stand back.
Hello, monsieur. Look at his face, Brett. Look at his face. Like, really tries to be in trouble. Like, he barely ever said a word, bro. Barely.
Because she was not in a good state. So we had to stand back and let medical professionals work with her. But
you could tell the dad wanted to say something, but the dad is just supporting his girls. Okay, no man is gonna defy his wife, and no man is ever gonna go against his daughter. So the father is just sitting there, like, you could tell that he's just very uncomfortable. Okay, and that's when I was like, all right, something is just not right here. And then it gets worse, because Carly, after all this time of people looking for her, she just shows up, y'all, on her parents' doorstep, walked there. And everybody's like, what the fuck happened to you? Where were you? What happened? We was looking for you. Parents continued to do more interviews, saying that they didn't know what to do. They were very confused. They didn't know how to approach it because she was in a bad state.
We tried to hug her as best we could, but I had to stand back because she was not in a good state.
Be fucking for real. The whole nation has been looking for this woman. People have donated so much money to this girl that they're not getting back, might I add. Bitch, y'all gonna be in a bad state if you don't tell us what the fuck she told you. So now everybody starts to get kind of annoyed, because it's like, where was she? What happened? What did she say? And now at this point, they have became the mouthpiece for their daughter, because they're not letting the daughter speak. So when Carly came home, she says that she checked out this toddler And when she checked out this toddler, she saw a man come through the woods and he grabbed her up. Mind you, there was never a weapon or anything mentioned in the story. So I guess he just forcefully told her to get in the car. She got scared and got in the car or the van or whatever it was. She gets in the car, takes her to some cabin. She said that there was a woman there, but she never like physically saw the woman. She could have been blindfolded. Y'all, what I'm telling you, the details of the shit never made sense. Long story short, they were playing with her hair. They were doing all this crazy shit to her. They fed her crackers. Y'all, she gives this elaborate Netflix plot type of story as to what happened to her while she was missing. And she did say that there was a child there. She gives a description of the man as being like, you know, I guess Caucasian with orange hair. And long story short, she said she did try to escape, but then, you know, she got caught the first time. But then when she tried to escape the second time, she got away and then she walked home. Now, of course, investigators did go and they tried to check this story out, but it didn't make any sense. So at this point, the cops are like, this shit is strange. Okay, like they're not understanding how any of this cooperates with anything, because one, they never found this child that was wandering out on the highway. Now, while all of this is going on, of course, they're making statements, okay? They're making statements on statements on statements on the internet, on the news and stuff like that. And everybody's asking for answers. And now everything on the internet is getting real crazy because there's now people that are like, we don't believe her. She don't make sense. And then, of course, there's people that, of course, especially when it comes to the Black community, we never want to admit that we're fucking wrong. And it really annoys the fuck out of me because it's like we could be faced with the truth. We could be faced with this person was bullshitting. This person was lying. This person has scammed us. But we will still sit there and be like, oh, but this, oh, but mental illness, oh, but, well, white people do this all the time. And I'm gonna get to that a little bit because I don't know why people be thinking, okay, when white people do this, they don't get as much punishment or as much criticism. That's fucking bullshit. Read or just look simple shit up. You could just type in, what happens when you lie to the police? People who have went to jail for lying to the police, you will fucking find it. So I don't know why you guys think that when people do this shit, they don't get punished. It happens all the fucking time. So we're gonna get into that a little bit later. But it's just like, y'all are mad ridiculous. Just admit and take the L that you believe somebody that was fucking lying. It happens all the time. So essentially, it gets to the point where the police, okay, are just trying to wrap their heads around how her story makes sense because it's not making sense. But I feel like the police were more so annoyed by the fact that they wasted so much resources. Black people going missing, they do not ever pull out all these stops, but they pulled out the stops for this girl. So I feel like they were also trying to like legitimize this in a way because it was hard to believe that anyone would have lied about something like this. So now everyone is like, okay, clearly something's up and clearly this has to be a lie, but why? So this comes into the internet theories, okay? Now, personally, I don't like to spin theories. I do not like to put theories out on the internet, especially not on my channel, because one, liability, and two, it's not journalistically ethical to do so, but I'm just gonna run through them really quick. Of course, there's the overrunning theory that a man broke up with her and that's why she did all of this. To be quite honest with you, I don't know how much I believe that, but I mean, it would be plausible because from the ages of like 21 to 26, a lot of us can be boy crazy and really dumb when it comes to men. So I will say that, okay, that's possible. Another one was that, you know, she possibly got fired from her job because there was a situation where they were saying that she stole money from her job prior to doing all of this. And essentially, you know, since she stole money from her job, that, okay, you know, she was probably just going through a spiral. People were saying it was a combination. She got fired, her man left her, so she did all of this to get attention. I'm not gonna lie, it kind of sounds plausible. And then, of course, there's the whole mental health thing, right? But, you know, authorities were saying there was no mental health, you know, involved in this, and she was evaluated. But what I need y'all to understand is, you could be perfectly healthy and do something like this. You could also be mentally ill, but be high functioning. Like, I'm high functioning, but I have bipolar disorder. I have anxiety. I suffer from depression and stuff like that. So, and I also take medication, but I'm high functioning. So I'm trying to understand, like, I don't know who the fuck evaluated her. They could be right. They could be wrong. But I'm trying to understand why people find it hard to believe that people do shit like this and they're not mentally ill, or vice versa. So it's just like, nonetheless, she did this shit and she fucking lied, okay? Because shortly after all of this, she came forward via her lawyer. Her comes forward with a statement saying she lied. and she's sorry.
My client apologizes for her actions to this community. It was no kidnapping.
Chief Nicholas Derzes read a statement from Russell's attorney.
The volunteers who were searching for her, to the Hoover Police Department and other agencies as well, as to her friends and family.
Don't nobody want your soggy ass sorry. All right. At that point, you should have just shut the fuck up. Fast forward to yesterday, we found out that Ms. Carly has been found guilty of staging her kidnapping. And the judge recommends an $18,000 fine and 1 year in jail.
Carly, why did you lie? Why did you lie to the public, Carly? Where were you for those 49 hours, Carly? Carly, where were you for those 49 hours? You have anything to say to the community for lying to the community? Everyone was out there searching for you, Carly. You have anything to say, Mr. and Mrs. Russell? Anything to say? Why did you lie on national TV? Anything to say, Carly?
I feel like that is the perfect punishment. I don't feel like she needs to spend 10 years in jail. I don't feel like she needs to spend, you know, $50,000 on whatever. But at the same time, I do feel like she probably should spend a little bit more money. Now that I think about it, like now that I just said that out loud, I'm like, no, maybe she should spend a little bit more money because there was so much police resources that were spent on finding this girl. So the fact that they talking about some $18,000 and 1 year in jail, I don't know. That search was pretty extensive. That was a lot of press runs. And that's a lot of money that was going to GoFundMe or whatever that nobody's ever going to see again. So yeah, no, it's not enough for me. I guess it's enough to make an example out of her, which I guess was the point. But no, okay? And there's a lot of people that are like,
nah, okay, I understand the $18,000 fine, but no, she shouldn't be going to jail.
What about all these other people that do all these things and don't go to jail?
Clearly, you people don't fucking read and you guys don't know what Google is for or DuckDuckGo. Those of you guys who don't believe in Google and think that, you know, Google is whitewashed, but okay, for those of you guys who know what Google is and don't want to use DuckDuckGo, Jussie Smollett spent $150,000 for his fucking little stunt. At least with Carly, she admitted to lying. I mean, she didn't say it out of her mouth, okay? She was out here strutting like it was a fucking runway, just sheshing all, acting like she ain't do nothing. And then we have Miss Martha Stewart. A lot of people think that Martha Stewart went to jail for inside trading. No, Martha Stewart is a convicted liar, my friends. She went to federal prison for 5 months, West Virginia. After that, unsupervised release for 2 years. She had to pay a huge fine to the SEC, and then she had to step down from being the CEO of her own company, all because she lied to the feds. All because of obstruction of justice and making false reports to the SEC and the FBI. So now we got Haldeman, right? So he served as President Richard Nixon's first White House chief of staff. He was convicted alongside John Mitchell, one of Nixon's attorney generals. This was in 1975. So he was convicted of conspiracy, obstruction of justice, and perjury related to testimony he gave to Senate Watergate Committee investigating the cover-up of the Watergate break in at the Democratic National Committee's headquarters. So he was sentenced to a maximum of 8 years in prison, but that was later on reduced to 1 to 4 years. He wound up serving only 18 months, but Mitchell served 19 months in prison. So help me understand, right? Y'all think that a regular civilian like fucking Carly's not gonna go to the jail? Are y'all fucking dumb? Celebrities like Martha and Jussie and people in the fucking White House are going to jail for perjury and lying to the feds, but y'all think Carly's about to not go? Shut the fuck up. Okay, just do quick Google searches. All I had to type in was people who went to jail for lying to the feds, and I found this information. Stop being dumb. And better yet, stop being like,
oh, well, because she's black. Oh, well, she must have been going through something. Oh, because mental illness.
Who cares? Who cares? Deal with your shit. Better go to therapy. Sit in the fucking therapist chair. Y'all need to stop this shit. Stop going easy on these people. Who, like, she sat here having people pray for her, making all this content about her, thinking that she was like literally lost and afraid and dying and getting held captive. Meanwhile, she was out here probably eating Cheez-Its somewhere, chilling, laughing, and looking at the coverage. Like, this is ridiculous. Y'all need to be fucking for real. Why the hell should she not go to jail? If people like Martha Stewart and the president's chief of staff could go to jail for lying to the feds, why shouldn't she? I'll wait.
Please, I want somebody to give me a legit logical reason why Carly Smollett should not be going to jail. I really want to understand. And now there's that whole conversation of, okay, well, this is definitely going to make things harder for Black women when they go missing. Yeah, absolutely correct. It is. And y'all can thank Miss Carly Smollett for that. Okay? Carly made everything worse. It's bad enough that we don't get attention when we go missing. We're labeled as runaways. We're labeled as liars, scammers. And most of the time, people don't care about us when we're alive and we're well. But when we're missing, it's like, yes, finally, another nigga gone. This is not going to help the situation. But you know what is going to help the situation? Ebony alerts. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, California has now rolled out this new thing called Ebony alerts, which alerts people when Black women go missing. I'm sorry for laughing. This is fucking ridiculous.
California now has a new tool to help find missing Black youth. Amber Alerts have been around for 2 decades, and since that time, more than 370 children and at-risk individuals have been located. But some critics say African Americans are often overlooked.
The sense of urgency is not there.
African Americans, whether they're children or young adults, often listed as runaway
by the notification system.
You see the difference of when white girls go missing and Black girls go missing.
So how is an Ebony alert different?
A Amber alert is for 17 years or younger.
Black youth considered at risk or with mental or physical challenges will qualify.
Expanding the age from 12 to 25.
California also has blue alerts for suspects who attack a law enforcement officer, silver alerts for missing seniors and people with disabilities, and feather alerts for missing indigenous people.
I thought we banned segregation. I thought we wanted to be equal, ladies and gentlemen. Why the fuck are we segregating Black people going missing from the white people? Child, what is this? Oh my God. I don't want to even hear anybody commenting down below. Oh my God, y'all ain't never happy with anything. Shut the fuck up. I never wanted segregation. I wanted equal rights and opportunity. Amber alerts are supposed to be for when children go missing. All of them, not just the pretty little blonde hair, blue-eyed kids. Okay, it's for the nigger kids too. All right? It's for the Hispanic kids. It's for the Asian kids. It's for the Indian kids. I ain't never hear about an Indian kid going missing, have you? I ain't never heard about a little Asian kid going missing, have you? Amber alerts are supposed to be for all the goddamn kids, is it not? The issue here is people might automatically see that and be like, oh, it's a nigger, fuck it. That's the problem here. People are going to see that shit and be like, oh, a little Black child's missing, who cares? Or better yet, it makes it even worse. Oh, there's a Black child missing. If I'm a T-R-A-F-F-I-C-K-E-R-er, yeah, I might want to snatch that child up for my enterprises. Do you feel me? Like, it's not going to make things better. If anything, it's going to make things worse. All right? I don't, like, if one thing, oh my God.
All right, y'all. So let me just clarify here, right? So us segregating ourselves is really just going to make things worse. So when we're sitting here saying like, okay, yeah, we have this system here for Black women and Black children when they go missing. So we're going to have to rely on white resources, are we not? Do you really think that white people, if we segregate ourselves, are going to help us? I haven't seen an all Black police force yet. Haven't seen an all Black SWAT team. I haven't seen an all Black town nonetheless. Like, what I'm trying to say is we're not here yet, right? As soon as we try to segregate ourselves and try to say, oh, we're going to find our own Black kids. We're going to do our own Black thing. They're going to bomb it. It's like Black Wall Street, just like everything else. We're just not at a place where we could sit there and segregate ourselves and be like, okay, we're going to handle our own Black issues. We have so many things that we have to tackle that don't require segregation. I've always fought for and believe in equality at the end of the day. And when it comes to shit like this, it takes villages to find missing kids. And it shouldn't be a question of Black or white. That's why I'm just like, why the fuck are we trying to separate this? It shouldn't even be like that. And it's sad because when you really think about it, it is like that. When Black kids go missing, it is like that. A lot of people already don't give a fuck. But if we sit here and we make a separate alert specifically for, you know, kids who are Black, they're gonna be like, oh, well, it's just a nigga kid. We really don't care. Oh, well, y'all separated yourselves. Why y'all need our help now? That's exactly what it's gonna be.
Do I even need to go into, I'm not even gonna go into the fact that that's a horrible, There better be a real child named Ebony behind this. And there might be, I didn't even bother to look it up because I just couldn't stop laughing. And then I threw my phone and I was like, I just need to sit in front of the camera. I'm not looking up. I don't care. I'm choosing to be ignorant as to why they chose the name Ebony. And I'm going to sit here. I'm going to own it. Journalistic integrity out the fucking window. With that being said, let me know what you guys think about Carly Smollett. Yes, that's her name. I don't care. It's not Carly Russell. It's Carly Smollett. Let me know what you guys think about this whole situation down below. Do you guys believe that she deserves more than 1 year in jail? Do you guys believe that she deserves more than an $18,000 fine? And most importantly, do you guys think that Ebony alerts are going to make a difference? And do you think that they should be issued as a federal, worldwide, nation, I said worldwide, nationwide thing? Because honestly, I'm not even gonna look into that shit anymore. Stop it, just stop it now. With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Please make sure you go buy some merchandise. I would appreciate it a lot. Thank you. Thank you so much. And I will see you guys on my Haitian channel for 12 Days of Halloween. Bye.